to each one of you to this place this morning as we mourn the death of Tabitha. Support those who grieve for this young man and comfort each other. Would you please, please put up with me for a moment. I've got some housekeeping to do. The toilets are, as you come in from outside, to the left. No, the right, sorry. If you hear a loud continuous alarm, don't panic, but we need to evacuate the building. And there are designated fire wardens who will help. All emergency exits have a green sign above them. The assembly point is either the far side of the hockey enclosure, or if you were shooting out the doors on the other side, just out into the car park. I'd ask you to turn off your cell phones, please, or put them on silent for this time. After the funeral, you're invited upstairs for tea and coffee, and later at 1 o'clock to join at the Alpine Energy Stadium for refreshments. My name is Sue Dixon, and it is totally my privilege to lead this time today. A funeral is set aside as a time to acknowledge a death, a time to say a formal goodbye to someone. It's a time to cry. It's a time to laugh. It's a time for memories, and a time to come to terms with how each of you is personally grieving. Be gentle with yourselves. Be kind to each other. Grieving for a loved friend is hard work. They say time heals, but it is more that we hold the raw grief of right now, and in the days to come, it will be held in a different way. This morning, do not be scared of the emotions as they come, like waves on a beach. Feel them. Cry. Shout quietly. Or get angry. But not for long. You couldn't have changed anything, nor can you change anything now. We can all assume what caused Tabitha to end his life, but we really don't know what another person is thinking or dealing with in their emotional lives. We are humans too, and not so good at mind reading. Tabitha, in the time that you had here on earth, you lived a full life. And you know, the very best way that we can celebrate that life that he lived amongst us is to talk about him, remember him, and hold him in our hearts for as long as we live. We're now going to hear from friends and family as they share some of their life stories of Tabitha. Shania, do you like to come forward?
Good morning, everyone. Thank you for coming here today to honour the life of Tabitha Anthony Kareka. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Shania Kareka, this is Glory, Liana and Aisha, and Steve. We are Tabitha's sisters and this is his dad. Tevita, or Vita as we called him, was our big brother, our champion. He wasn't your stereotypical older brother that would pick on you from time to time. All we remember from our childhood is nothing but happiness, kindness, and love. Never been a day when we didn't have him to protect us, to guide us, and to give us that boost if we needed it.
Our Vita was an incredible human being with so much to give. He was admired by many people he met and had always put others before himself. His hard work, his caring nature, his goofiness, and his love of life are some of the many traits that characterise us as an amazing person. Tevita was born on the 9th of May, 1989, in Timaru, and he would have celebrated his 32nd birthday this Sunday. We wish you just waited one more day, Vita. Then you would have been home. And we could have helped keep you safe. And we could have celebrated your birthday together too.
Life changes radically, but memories, they don't. And for that, we're eternally grateful. Thank you for teaching us to dance before the music is over and live before your life. I'd just like to finish off with a wee poem. Today is full of memories of a brother laid to rest, and every single one of them is filled with happiness. For you were someone special, always such a joy to know, and there was so much pain when it was time to let you go. That's why this message is sent to heaven above, for the angels to take care of you and give them all my love.
Brian, Tevita's cousin. He's definitely more than a cousin to me. We grew very close. I'd like to thank everyone for helping out. It's been amazing. Everyone's made it really good and stress-free. There was a lot of good times. Sort of hard to, I guess, pinpoint one, but there's a moment that I always remember. I went and stayed with Rachel and Tevita for a few weeks. I remember we were just walking the streets, as you do when you're a teenager, and Tevita had some spray paint. I really needed to go to the toilet. And he asked me what to write, and I said, I need to poo. So he decided to tag that on the brick wall, like right next to the road where everyone could see. And we just, laughed. And I guess that was, the moment where I realized that he had the same immature, sick humor as me. So, the only real thing I want to ask everyone a favour is try and make at least one Tevita joke every day. I know that's how he'd like to be remembered, and he'll be there laughing with you. Thank you.
Cam and Liz, your turn.
just want to say a quick thing before I share some stories. There's going to be a haka at the end there. So if you know the haka, please feel free to join. My first impression of Tevita, it was Wellington Intermediate. It was lunchtime. We're down the basketball courts with one of my good friends, Chris Duffy. And we're down the basketball courts pretty much most lunchtimes. But there's this one particular lunchtime I always remember. There's this other guy sort of down the other end of the court. And he didn't have a ball on him or anything like that. But he was just running up and touching the rim of the hoop, which was just unheard of back then for a 12 or 13 year old to be doing, you know. And me and Duffy, we kind of look at each other and we're like, who was this guy over here? Like, this, we never seen anything like this. And by now you probably know who this guy is. Tevita not only could leap like a leopard, but he could run like a gazelle. So anyway, I'm looking at this guy at the other end of the court. I walk up to him, tap him on the shoulder, and I say to him, you want to come play? In that small moment, we formed a lifelong brotherhood. And Tevita, he had many good qualities that I admired as a friend. He had the charming wit like the Fresh Prince, the swagger of the style like Chris Brown, and he had that competitive nature like Kobe. But one attribute I learned from him from a very young age, and I try to practice it every day, and that's just to live life in the moment. Tevita, he was just a present person. Like when you're with him, nothing else mattered. Like you could be in the garage, just a toy with a beer, you'd still have the best time, mate. Real pleasure to be around sort of guy. And, you know, his face would be so sore from smiling that whole time you spent time with him. So those wee moments are some of the memories I always cherish. Tevita was also, you know, he was a bit of a ladies' man as well. He was quite a charmer. I always remember this one time he was teaching me a dance move he just learned. And he was like showing it off at all the nightclubs around Noosa. And he goes, Liz, I want to teach you this new dance move I've got for you. I was like, all right, let's see it, mate. And he goes, oh, that's it. Let's get all the day out of the way. I go to him. It's not good. It's okay. And then I go to him, I've put this new dance from the South, and it's been on the internet, it's everywhere, everyone knows it. I'm surprised you don't know it. And it goes like this. He goes, let's see it. I got this. Yeah, you probably might have seen that one as well. And he kind of looks at me weird, eh? And he goes, yeah, that's the dance move I'm trying to do. Like, mate, you're dancing like a chicken. But in all seriousness, Tevita, real dear friend to me, and to Rachel and the family, you really did raise a really good man. I thank you for that. He was a big part of my life and everyone here as well. And Tevita, I'll always remember you. You'll never be forgotten, mate.
Hello everybody, I'm Dan, for those of you that haven't met me. I just want to share a quick story as I walked in today. So 2 weeks ago, I sent Tevita a song and I said, this is a banger, man. Play this one loud, but don't play it in front of the ladies. And as we sat down, the song came on the speakers just in the end. So, he's always pissing me off, eh? So I met Tevita when he arrived at Timaru Boys as a year 9, or as the Boys High Boys called it, a turd former. He was always watching us play at lunchtime, and we didn't let him play because we didn't let turd formers play. Just like Les said, we saw him jumping around, touching the basket at 12, 13 years old, and we'd just never seen anything like it. So we let him play. He couldn't catch the ball, but he could get up. He could get upstairs and swing on the rim. It was incredible. So he was instantly part of the basketball crew. It's incredible that we're in this stadium and it's Friday, and tonight is Friday night basketball. And I'm sure all of you that have been around Timaru know that that was his showground. And I'm actually surprised we're allowed in here today, because I've watched him vandalize every basket in here. He was a star of the show, and you know, half the people watch him were just there to watch him in the warm-up. He was a freak athlete, and we've never seen anything like it, eh? We had athletics day out here on the track one day, and half an hour before his 100-meter track race, I went up to him, I said, "Hey man, what's up, you good to go?" He said, "Yeah, I'm ready, yeah." I said, "Well, you don't look ready, man, you're eating Burger King and you got no shoes." And he laughed and set a 100-meter track record. I took Tevita to me to Waitaki Boys for a year, much to the disgust of everybody in Timaru. But he returned for his final year, and his heart was here, and he was always going to come back. After school, we both sort of went on our journeys. A lot of it was revolved around basketball. Tevita went to the NZIS. Shout out to those boys that have come down for this. We spent some time in Christchurch, Dunedin. And then he went to Australia, where he truly became a professional. He was a mentor, he was a trainer, he was a coach. He rang me one day when he was over there and he said, I've had a great time here, eh? But if something I've learnt, the thing that's most important to me is my boys, my friends and my family, and it's time to come home. he was always joking, eh? The more serious the moment, the more he's going to joke, always pissing us off. One summer we came back to Timaru, and I was a bit pissed off, to be honest. We didn't have any work. There was no basketball to play. We were just kind of dragging our feet around. So he says, "I'm coming to get you, man. We're going to sort our stuff out. We're going to go get some money." And so we go down the wings. We sign up and get the benefit for a bit. And he's hyping me up every day. He's like, "Hey, man, Tuesday, payday. Pack and save, boy. That's us, boy. Pack and save." So the day comes close, get to Tuesday, picks me up in the blue Beamer, and we head down to Pick and Save. I'm still pissed off, but we walk around the Pick and Save, and he's about 5 meters ahead of me. He knew I was pissed off, and he starts putting things in the trolley and thanking people. I'm looking at him like, "What are you doing, man?" Thanking people, put some bread in the trolley, "Thank you, thanks man." Put something, and he shakes this person's hand, "Thank you." And I catch up with him, and I get up to where he is, and I say, what are you doing, man?" He says, I'm just thanking all these taxpayers for our groceries." He was always hassling me for my clothes. He was the man. He dressed up good. I dressed shit. So he said to me one day, "We need to get you some threads, man. We're going to go, I've got to hook up. So we arrive at Graham's op shop. And there's a fresh new batch of suits that have arrived. And we get a suit each. He says to me, "Hey, if I ever say to you, suit up, you put the suit on, don't ask any questions. Put it on." So the next day, I get a message, "Suit up. I'm picking you up in half an hour." The blue Beamer arrives, I get in there, and we go downtown, we park up. He's got a six-pack of diesels. We sit in the Beamer and listen to Lil Wayne, and go into the Monkey Bar and do the Cat Daddy all night. We're in Christchurch, and I get the message again, "Suit up. Pick you up in half an hour." I get in the car. I said, what's the occasion now, man? What have we got? He says, Wendy's Burgers, opening night. We're there. We're standing in the line, and someone turns around and says, looks at him and goes, why are you wearing that suit? And Tavita said, why aren't you wearing a suit? It's Wendy's, it's opening night, what are you doing? He rang me one time, he said, oh, I'm going to do the showman, the Bachelorette. I said, I can't watch another one of these shows. Don't do that. He said, I said to him, tell me why you're going to do it. Sell it to me. And he said, I'm actually going to use it as a platform. I'm going to shine a light on some mental health. And to his credit, he did a great job. And he inspired people. He shined a light on that through sharing some of his own troubles. He helped others. He was always talking to me about the importance of his friends and family. And those of you that are in here that are closest to him, I know you know how he felt about you. I just want to say to you, man, like, I couldn't be prouder of you, eh? You inspired me. There were times I looked at you, man, and the odds were stacked against you. But you battled adversity, and you achieved things most of us could never reach. And you did it with a joke and a smile. I know this was a mistake, man. I know you wanted to keep fighting. When a brother makes a mistake, you get the forgiveness from your brothers. We forgive you, man. You showed me a lot, man. I want to thank you. You showed me how to open up. You showed me how to lighten up. You showed me how to laugh. You showed me how to cry, even when, though you put me out afterwards, but you showed me. Your legacy will live on, man. It's going to live on through the people that you've reached, through your brothers, through your family. Everybody in here. I know you can rest now. I know you're standing in a line waiting for Kobe's autograph. I know you will be with Peter. We'll see you, brother.
And how amazing he was, even though he probably loved that. so won't do that. Vita made me feel important, like my thoughts mattered and my voice was heard. He was my best friend, my boy, and I always knew that I was a part of a group that he had all the time in the world for. But it wasn't until we put us all together that I fully understand the gravity of what that means. I was seeing him sit on the couch with my kids. I miss him popping over just to spend time with my partner and I. I miss the jokes, the love, and he'll even miss cleaning his room for all the time. I miss the man I saw him become, and I miss more than anything the man I knew he would have been. He'll always be my bridesman. You were there during my struggles, and you're going to be there through my joy. I take comfort in knowing you'll be there keeping your granddad swaggy, playing ball with Kobe, and vibing with Nipsey. I also know you'll get to meet Zeno, and she'll love you just as much as the rest of my family did. I'll love you forever, and I'll miss you even longer. I miss forever. So, Rachel would like her friend Annette to come and say a few words on behalf of her for Vita. So, if Annette could come up, that would be great.
Marie is Tavita's grandma, who he loved very much. Grandma, on behalf of my family, I'd like to thank you all for coming today. The love and support has been heartwarming. I always cherished Tavita right since he was a little baby. Continue on forever. We will all take a moment to remember the happy memories of Tavita and smile as he would have wanted to be remembered that way. I have a message that Rachel wrote to Tavita when he first left home as a young fella, and he has always kept it with him. To my little son, one of the hardest things a mother can do is to let her son grow up and leave home. Your happiness means more to me than anything in this world. I'm very proud of you, and I love you with all my heart. I know you will always do well in life. You're a wonderful son with a kind heart. Sorry, I'm shaking real bad. I'll miss you more than you'll ever know. I would do anything for you to make sure you are okay. I love you always, Mum. And these are Rachel's words from today. Tavita was my best friend, my life coach, my son. There are no words to bring back my boy. I'll miss his good morning sunshine I got every day. And good night, Mother Dearest, which was the last thing he said to me. I was so proud of him, and I love him so, so much. Life is never going to be the same again. Good night, Vita. Love you. Just a side note for myself. I know Lobie since he was a little boy. Lobie, gonna miss your smile, your teasing, and those great big bear hugs. Shine on, crazy diamond.
Can't be here today.
sometime. 1910, my friend. Try to black it out, but it plays again. When it's real, feelings hard to conceal. Can't imagine all the pain I feel. Give anything to hit half a breath. I know you're still living your life now.
Talk about them. Also, I'm always one message away. So, have an awesome day, guys. Kia ora, everyone. My name's Chris Duffy. Just good friends growing up in Timaru, all through school and high school. I requested to do a quick video message, seeing as I can't be at the funeral. And so I'd just like to thank Cam for allowing this video message to be played. Also, I want to acknowledge, first and foremost, Rachel and the family. My sincerest heartfelt condolences go out to you, Rachel, and the rest of the family. Words can't begin to describe what you guys are going through, and I just want you guys to know that he was such a loved and caring human being, and he'll be sorely missed, and his legacy will live on forever. My thoughts and prayers go out to you guys. A brief background on my friendship with the brother. I've known him since 2001, so it's around about 20 years now, and we met at Wellington Intermediate. And it was there that we sort of started to click with each other. Also, with Les, the bro Les, it was pretty much just us three in terms of, we hung out a lot because of basketball.
And that friendship continued to high school at Timaru Boys, where we continued to hang out. And we just got along like so well, like we were brothers. We were into the same music, the same sports, the same everything. We loved wrestling, the same cartoons. It was just an amazing friendship, and I always cherish those memories in school. I didn't see much of the brother after school. Our paths took us in different directions. I think he went off to Australia, whilst I stayed in New Zealand. But when I got married in 2018, before that, I actually reached out to the brother and asked if he could come to my wedding. And no hesitation, he hopped on that plane and he showed up. And the same with Liz. And I was so grateful to see two of my best friends at my wedding. And so, yeah, that was such a great time. I was so glad they were able to come. We made some good memories in Samoa, to add on to some cherished memories that we made in school growing up. So the last few years, I didn't get to see much of Tavita physically. I called him Tavita, but growing up, it was Tavita or Vita. But, you know, the bro was many things, but there's one thing I remember him for. It's for being a proud Polynesian, proud Pacific Islander. And so I just want to honour that today by calling him Tavita, because I know that's what my mum used to call him whenever he came around. And I know that's what my people will call him. So, yeah, I just want to honour that today. He never heard it come out of my mouth that way. He always heard Vita or Tavita. So, yeah, my apologies, brother, but there's a first time for everything. Never saw much of Tavita physically in the past few years, but we always kept in touch. We last talked on Wednesday, last week. That was the last time I heard from the brother. He sent a message about something. He always used to send these messages, and just to see how we were. We have our own little group chat, just me, Liz, and Tavita. You know, we used to share that a lot, share memes, funny videos and stuff, but he was always the one that kept the chat, you know, he kept the chat going. Life gets busy a lot, and I was just so glad that he was always there just to check in on us. And that's something I want to miss from the brother. I just want to, I know there's a lot of people that have a lot to say, and so I'll just keep this short, but I just want to end this video message with a passage that we usually say in Samoa during funerals. It's a well-known passage from the Bible, and it goes, I'm just trying to think of it now. And it basically means, blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. It really hit home for me, that verse today, because I know there will be a lot of people mourning right now, but I just want everyone to know that we're all in this together and we can all comfort each other. And the memories that we created with the brother can help us through. And so, yeah, I just want everyone to know that we're not alone in this, and we can help each other. We can remember the bro for being the great guy that he was. And so, yeah, I just want to end my video message on that note. Once again, my sincerest heartfelt condolences to Rachel and the family. I just want to make a shout out as well to the bros from Timaru Boys High and also Mountain View. I know a lot of us will be hurting right now. Also, Roncalli. Yeah, I can't forget the bro Justice, Justin Hickey. I know, he had a very close friendship with the brother as well. And so I just want to acknowledge all my brothers mourning right now, also my sisters, and also Rachel and the family. Hope to see everyone soon. Sorry again, I can't be there, but I know you guys will send the bro off in a way that only we can do in Timaru. Uso, Mwiano Malanga. I hope to see you soon, my brother, and I'll always remember you forever. Peace.
we're now going to watch a final video, which is a time of reflection, a time for us all to hold to in our hearts those wonderful memories that we have. The music which goes with it is Lost by 660. Commit his body to be cremated. After that, his casket will be taken from this place to the crematorium and a haka will be performed. Nothing can hurt you again, and nothing will. Tabitha, we now commit your body to be cremated. Ashes to ashes. dust to dust. Rest in peace this day.